Hello everyone, welcome to Elasticsearch training. My name is Gaurav and I will be your trainer for this course. So before we start our Elasticsearch training, let me first introduce myself. So guys, my name is Gaurav. I am working with Koenig Solutions as a technical lead. I'm Microsoft certified trainer and DevOps trainer. I deal with technologies like GitHub, Docker, Puppet, Chef, Kubernetes, Ansible, Elasticsearch, Logstash, Kibana, Terraform, and many more. In terms of training delivery, I have delivered trainings for many corporate clients like Red Hat, Cisco, Accenture, VMware, Dell, SAP, and even for many government agencies. I have many certifications as well in different platforms like Linux, Kubernetes, and Terraform. So this is all about me, guys. So let's start our Elasticsearch training. So Elasticsearch, very first thing is what we are going to cover in our session. So let me open our table of content. First thing we will discuss, what is Elasticsearch? What are the use cases of Elasticsearch? And Elasticsearch, we will use terms like index, document. So we will see what is the meaning of those terms. Okay, so let's go. We know what we are going to cover. So very first question come into mind is, what is ELK stack? Whenever we say Elasticsearch, so we'll always hear one term, ELK stack. Now what is ELK stack? ELK stack is actually, you can say these are three tools. So what we can do, let's suppose we have servers running, right? Maybe this is our servers. Now, from this web server, or this can be any type of server or network device, anything. What do you want is you want to collect log and you want to store in your Elasticsearch cluster. So I'm assuming this is my Elasticsearch cluster. Now, very first question is, how data will come from this VM or from this server to Elasticsearch? So we will use Logstash. So what Logstash will do? Logstash will collect the data from the source and then will give data to Elasticsearch. Because of Elasticsearch is only to analyze queries, right? And to store information. But who will give information to Elasticsearch? Logstash. Well, there are other tool also available to fetch data, but let's talk about Logstash first. So Logstash will fetch data and then will store in Elasticsearch. Now guys, in Elasticsearch, when we will have data, so to manage data, it is very difficult. Managing data is very difficult part in Elasticsearch because of you need to remember the commands. And maybe sometime you want to create a graphical dashboard. Maybe you want to create some visualized picture of your data. So this is not possible within Elasticsearch. So then what we will do, we will use tool called Kibana. So what is Kibana? Kibana is visualization tool. So now we understood Logstash to fetch data, Elasticsearch, where we will have data, and Kibana, which will use Elasticsearch data, and then we can create visualized picture. So this is the meaning of ELK. Now you may well say, Gaurav, why we are not seeing LEK? Well, this is not in our hand. It's created by Elastic company. So they said ELK, Elasticsearch, Logstash, and Kibana. Okay, there is no reason why they gave ELK. Now, there are many companies who are using ELK, like Dell, LinkedIn, Cisco, Netflix, Medium. These are all big organizations. Now, if these organizations can use Elasticsearch for their data processing, so we can also use, right? And another part why Elasticsearch is very famous, reason is it's free. Very first reason, it is free tool. and it is open source tool. Anyone can download and anyone can start working on it. This is the main reason why Elasticsearch is very famous. Well, guys, even though Elasticsearch is free tool, but we can do many things. We can analyze our data, we can query our data, right? And even we can use as a search engine. That's up to you. We can use ELK for free. Now, for your information, maybe sometime you need support. Maybe you don't want to depend on open source. If you are using open source and if something goes wrong, then you will need to manually fix those issues. But if you have enterprise version, then what is the benefit? You can work on your tool, and in case if any issue will come. So what you can do, you can simply call to support, right, in ELK support, and then they will provide the solution. This is the benefit when you go with the Elasticsearch license. Otherwise, this is free. Well, one thing I want to tell you here in Elasticsearch support licensing is very amazing. Reason? You know, Elasticsearch is a combination of multiple tools. So you don't need to purchase everything. If you want support for Elasticsearch, they will only provide support for Elasticsearch. This is not like you will need to take support for ELK everything. No, you can take support for any particular tool which you are using in your company. So this is that's why Elasticsearch is famous. Now, when we say Elasticsearch, so Elasticsearch is actually not Elasticsearch, Elasticsearch. So when we say Elasticsearch, so Elasticsearch is a combination of multiple tools like Elasticsearch, Logstash, Kibana, Bates, and XPath. So guys, if I will talk about Elasticsearch, so Elasticsearch was mainly created for search engine, but now we are using for many purposes. And another benefit is Elasticsearch is scalable up to petabytes of data. And you can store structured data or unstructured data, it's up to you. Any kind of data you can store in Elasticsearch. And open source, we discussed this many times. And other part is Elasticsearch is famous in terms of enterprise also. Now here, guys, in our training, we will be installing Elasticsearch cluster in our machine, right? I will provide you lab details in some time. But if you will go for Elastic Cloud, we also have Elastic Cloud. I'm showing you Google Elastic Cloud. So what you can do, you can purchase Elastic Cloud. And the benefit is the same Elasticsearch cluster you will get on Elastic on the cloud. And benefit of cluster is whenever you need more machines in order to store more data, then cloud benefit is that it will automatically create a new machine and then you can store your data. And another part is Elasticsearch is not particularly related to one cloud. They are providing you solution. They are saying if you want to go with AWS, you are happy. It means you are free to go. If you want to go with Microsoft Azure, you are free to go. And also Google Cloud. So these are the benefits. So Elasticsearch, even in the enterprise version or cloud version, they are giving you full control. It's up to you. Whenever you want to create, wherever you want to create, you can create. And then you can utilize in a more better way. Because the best practice is use Elasticsearch on cloud. Reason? Whenever we will need more and more data, then Elastic Cloud will automatically create more machine. And this is the benefit of Elastic Cloud. Now, one thing guys, today we will have a little bit theory. We need to understand this theory. Now, when I am speaking, and if you think you have question, feel free to raise your hand. You can see we have one icon in Teams. You can raise your hand. And then I will come to you, okay? Or even you can put in chat box in case if any queries will come. Now we have other tool called Kibana. So what is Kibana? Kibana is visualization tool. And with this, we can create graphs easily. We can create pie chart. We have many things. And you know, even people who knows Elasticsearch, they always love to work with Kibana. Reason, you don't need to write a long command in order to work with Elastic. You can just simple type queries of Elasticsearch and enjoy. Because of managing Elasticsearch with the REST API, direct Elasticsearch is a little bit challenging. But if you manage your Elasticsearch with Kibana, then it will be more easy for you. It will provide user-friendly interface. And the best part is you can create a visualized picture. Like, can you see here? We have visualized picture. And you can create as per you. You can see, like here we have something called flight data. So we are able to see how many flights are delayed, right? How many flights are canceled? How many flights we have total? So this is just a simple example, but you can create visualized picture of like this. Now we have Expert. Now, what is Expert? Expert is not in Elasticsearch by default. You need to enable. It will be installed with Elasticsearch, but you need to enable. By default, it will not be enabled. Now, benefit of Expert is, guys, you can manage your security. You can secure your Elasticsearch cluster. You can manage your users. You can manage your permissions. If you will not enable Expert in your Elasticsearch cluster, then you will not be able to manage security for your data in Elasticsearch. Now, in Expert, we also have paid versions. Like sometime what people do, they want weather forecasts, like machine learning. So machine learning is also possible with Expert, but by default, this is not enabled, as I said. And another part is security is free. You can implement as per your requirement, but alerting, reporting, machine learning, Elasticsearch SQL, graph, and monitoring. For this, you need to pay. Security is free, you can implement, but for other part, you will have to pay.
AWS is an open search, right? Does that by default support Expert or no? That's
you are saying AWS?
Open search is based out of Elasticsearch, right?
Yes, right.
So does it support Expert or no?
Yes, Expert is supported.
Okay.
But you can't use machine learning. This is paid feature.
Okay.